One, two, three.
Thank you so much.
You didn't see Joe in time, but I think you just got it. Yeah.
Crawling behind the camera.
Film, movies. And it just, but right now we've got it right up against that really long queue with the ice. Mm-hmm. Comes out of that and it goes into the plant.
Yeah.
So I don't know. We have to. That's a tricky one.
Yes.
And we have to listen to them first because I don't want to get into any recording unless I have seen what they are doing. Okay. And we have to keep Henry under control. We have to keep the drums under,
right,
percussion under control.
Yeah.
We probably have to keep the bass under control. I don't know what they are up to. We know what we will basically need.
Okay, all right, cool.
All right.
That shouldn't be too bad.
A session not very long ago with a great cello player from Holland, Ernst Reisiger. Strange thing was that there were Sardinian singers, a very, very ancient form of singing, probably dating back into prehistory, that kind of voices. And in addition, a Senegalese singer who had never met them before and who would not understand their language and sing in Wolof. And yet there's a mystery about music which makes these things possible. It's such a primordial beauty in it.
I've always been drawn to folk music, roots music. I stop at Barry Manilow. From a very early age, from when I was a kid, listening to Louis Armstrong and the Hot Five, you know, that's very crude music in one sense. In another sense, it's very sophisticated and advanced and harmonically interesting. But its surfaces are crude, and I suppose I fell in love with that sound when I was quite young, and it's something that I've always looked for. Sophisticated, but crude.
Now, what we would like to do is to do the big thing first, like in the beginning, and we have the same a similar motive towards the end, and in the middle of the film, there's a very decisive moment. What I need here is, it's not that I'm gonna fade in the music at the beginning. There has to be straightforward authority. I need the right on the spot authority. You set your foot down, mm-hmm. and this is the music. And I need to create space. When you look at this, you know how to do that. So. Space is very, very, very important.
Yeah, this is Alaska, big sky, big mountains, big everything.
And you see it constantly in the film, the kind of space that I want to create, and the music will create its own space, sure. What I've heard so far, Henry, when you are at the electric guitar, we may keep you under control somewhat.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because you, if you go too wild, I'll trample on your foot.
Right, yeah. Yeah. I think he was testing his parameters.
Your guitar has to be the lead, very, very, very clear lead, okay. and very much authority in it. And then all the rest will fall in place. We are not playing to the image that is on the screen. I think it should be much freer flowing, and we'll find a way to arrange the music with the images. So, okay. Go to work. Do your job.
Three, four.
Not into exactly the melody as it was. There's something modified here in the melody. Shall we listen for a second to it again, I'm always very, very straight. What I feel, what I think, and they always know that I'm not just applauding. Because everybody would applaud in a moment like that. I say there's something which I would like to have modified. I don't recognize the first introductory statement, for example, in a previous recording that we did. And I voice it immediately. Step down. It's too melodious how you are stepping in.
He's more authoritarian.
Yes, yes, yes. The very, very beginning. Plant your foot down. This is the law of the earth.
Okay.
You are too melodious into it. It says, settle the thing.
Okay, gotcha. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Change the planet.
Okay.
This is it, yeah.
So let's just do it. Yeah. Let's do it. Go.
Two. Thank you. you want music that transcends something, you know, that just goes beyond. And sometimes if it's rough and has that rough quality, it transcends. If you repeat music too often, if you rub the edges off music, you really take away the music itself. The music is in the edges, it's in the rough bits. If you smooth it over, there's really nothing left. You've got lots of notes left, but there's no music. So it's always a striving to keep it as something alive, you know, something fresh, something that has, you know, a vitality to it.
The first serious meeting with Richard, I said one thing: I need the raw soul of you. And I think you understood what I meant.
I hope so.
Yeah, because what we have in the film is has such a raw quality.
Absolutely, yes.
And we have to leave it as it is. There's no way to embellish it or to digitally enhance it or whatever. We just keep it as it is.
It's July 26th, and I've been dropped off all alone again here in the Grizzly Maze.
Even with the wind noise and so the that you hear, that's in Treadwell's microphone. So it's very raw and it has to stay like that, but the music has to be of the same quality, a soul that is raw. And with Richard, I think there is no one better for that, no doubt. It's very beautiful here.
It's extraordinary. For me, it is on this.
On the roof. Coming down. What are you doing up there? That's where you're sitting?
And I don't know, with a percussion has to be very discreet, otherwise it sounds like the hippie stuff in Golden Gate Park.
I think if it's
so
down lower.
So be careful. Be careful.
Yeah.
Just be careful with that one. Yes.
Okay.
Well, just check the leakage.
It was just.
Did not.
It's okay.
Okay.
The Golden
yes.
Gate Park thing was a little low.
Oh, sorry. That was a low blow.
I
yes.
can handle it.
You didn't say Sproul Plaza, at least.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. Yeah.
It was an opportunity for me to come out of my cage.
Okay. Oh yeah. Two, three, four. Quite often I thought, since Treadwell has been a filmmaker and people have not seen that, they always take him for the eco-warrior, the self-appointed eco-warrior, but I have seen that there's a great vision as a filmmaker in his footage. And I kept thinking, what sort of music would he have chosen? And I think he would have been right here in this studio with Richard Thompson and you and all the others.
How's the hair look? That's my story here. For me, Timothy Treadwell, the kind warrior. Can I take it? I'm trying. Okay, yeah, I can do it.
But why not? Why not? Across the halfway point. Government's given me all they have, so far. I've stood up to it. I've had danger in the boat, almost died.
See, he's a movie star. He's a star in his own movie here.
Do you want to reinforce it like his music and what you would imagine behind him, or do you want something
discreet,
background?
There's never anything like background music in my films, but...
I always cannot understand why girls don't want to be with me for a long time because I have really a nice personality. I'm fun.
I have a cue that builds a bridge to the... To the cue at the end, you know, the cowboy cue.
Yeah. So the cowboy cue seems more natural when it gets there.
Yeah. So some real, you know, really kind of crudely played a couple of guitars, perhaps a little kind of crude, like humming, like moaning. Sort of singing, you know.
We'll make a campfire. You can hum, and Jim and I will sit around.
Yeah, but only halfway there. Just like a bridge. I think we play it like you know, we've been up all night in a bar in Texas, and you know, it's that real sort of lazy, you know, lazy and burnt out kind of strum. You know?
Okay, well, really sloppy. Sure.
The premonition of the coyotes.
You've just had two bottles of wine and you know, I mean, it's you know, really.
So this is B3.
You know, the light should be dimmed and it should be 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. However, because we're professionals, we'll just...
this is not country and western music. You see, that's for the truckers, that's for the middle class America, and so. But this is for the cowboys. Right. That song is for the rodeo riders. That's for the real men.
Girls don't want to be with me for a long time because I have really a nice personality. I'm fun. I'm very, very good in the, you're not supposed to say that when you're a guy, but I know I am. They know I am. And I don't fight with them. I'm so passive. Bit of a patsy.
I loved the Coyotes. They were very good, actually, yes.
Yeah. It's very beautiful how it emerges of something melodious, and then all of a sudden you find these very, very strange dark tones.
I can thank God on my knees that cinema is probably the closest to music that you can find. Cinema is not really related that much to literature, or it's not that much related to other art forms like painting or so. It's very, very close to music. And I wish I could play an instrument. I'd like to play a cello, a cello like this here. I would give 10 years of my life if I could play it as we have seen and heard it in these 2 days.
Yeah.
10 years of my life easily.
No, wait. Have a look. Okay. Don't get carried away by the next image. Wait until...
And I started.
No. Wait until the man crosses.
Crosses now. Yeah.
Okay, he goes across and then
starts. Yeah, and
you see, it looks like complete harmony of man and beast, like him in unison with nature. Mm-hmm. We believe things are all right, and they are not when you find the dark menace in it. Yeah, yeah. Okay. And every single one who sees this says, ah, how beautiful, yeah, and how nice and how sweet, and the bear is swimming with him.
Right.
And it's not so.
Right. Okay.
That's it.
Yes, 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 yes.
Do you want one more, Werner?
No, come on. Don't drown it again. That was beautiful.
Yeah, I see where
a couple things are a little too obtrusive.
I like 250, I think. Like 235 or something.
I might decide to say buy two and make two copies of the very thing.
Oh, okay.
I might say that.
All right.
I'm going to go ask permission for that.
I'm here in the mixing maze, one of the most dangerous areas in all of the Bay Area. I'm here with the most dangerous director on Earth, Herzog. Now be quiet. We don't want him to hear us. Good boy. Stay away. Good idea to keep away from him.
What about prepared piano?
Let's not torture them anymore.
No,
come on.
Now. Do you want to do prepared piano electric guitar?
Sure.
Yeah. Let's do that.
Okay.
Yeah, I think so. This precise point.
Before we start, is that what you want, Henry?
You don't have to do whatever you want, but no, none of the bowed stuff. Not sustained, something that's just smooth. Okay, go.
One, two, three, four.
I've been always after something like a deeper truth, an ecstatic truth. I've been after balance, after something like justice within pictures. Very strange to explain it, and I've hardly ever seen a film that has complete balance within it. There are exceptions like Rashomon by Kurosawa. I'm sitting in awe and I think, how did he do that? How, for God's sake, can I get somewhat close to this? And of course, I never will, but trying it anyway is okay, and it gives some sort of of meaning to my life, and that you are in a certain way going for the essential, right, straight, without detour. Where is it? It's the essential I'm looking for what is the deepest essential that defines us as human beings. Yes. Yes, beautiful. Amazing, yes. Wow, yeah.
We put the big monitor back on. I just want to do one thing. I want to do something with you and Damon. Music inspired by the film Grizzly Man, not to be thought of as ever used film. Yeah. Okay. But I want to do the bear fight. Right. I just want to hear them play the bear fight.
Okay, let's do that. What actually happens is they are threatening each other, and they are going, and they are receding, and they are slowly, slowly, slowly building it up, and then abruptly it starts. Can you try to give a little bit more menace, 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 and then there's a clash, and then there's menace, 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 and then it goes into the real fight. And the strange thing is that it is not a clear end of the fight, because they are backing off and move with the same menace. Menace, 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 menace.
Yeah. Totally amazing. Yeah. Yeah.
There were visitors every now and then, but for Treadwell, they were just intruders, an encroaching threat upon what he considered his Eden. Even the Park Service itself became an enemy because of its restrictions.
When you're doing something like this, you don't always have the overview. If you're on a stage and you're playing music, there's less distractions. If you're in a studio and you're thinking about the picture and you're thinking about length and you're thinking about this, that, and the other, you have to be reminded sometimes of what's the point of what you're doing. So you need other people to let you know.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Not that many.
8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 cues we identified. No.
Come on.
Don't you want some new age music? Don't you want we get some pan pipes and some new age music?
Henry.
Hold on. What
are you saying? And maybe some real nice synthesizer going like. It's
better than like your dead type of thing. It's creepy, baby. It's creepy. It's Freddy Krueger creepy.
Sounds beautiful, let's do it. Here goes, we're rolling. This is the ghost in the something. Ghost in the...
Ghost one.
Ghost in the maze.
Ghost in the maze. Ghost in the maze. This doesn't affect that.
Let's just start.
This doesn't affect
no,
it.
No.
Maybe can I actually have Richard alone for the first 15, 20 seconds or so?
Good plan.
Still rolling? One.
Yes.
Two. Three.
Some of it is precision work, where you need 22 seconds. And nobody who sits here would understand why is it that we need 22 seconds and why do I need, even though you can't even develop a melody or anything, how do you find a natural end then? Very, very difficult to do that.
2, 3. Thank you.
And then while we've got this guitar out there, can you change one string to suspend the tuning in a different way and give me a 36-second piece?
Along the same general lines?
Yes, that relates to that theme, but I want you, it could be different harmonically. You could just change a string to make it different if you want.
Oh yeah, easy. That's so easy.
And how long is this, 30?
36, and it's, I need it pretty precisely timed to 36
seconds.
36
seconds.
But don't let them hear
that's
what it's called.
Okay, Rick. One, two.
And finally, let me just ask for one more of that, but not so active in the high pitch range in the beginning.
Are you up to this, Joe?
64 seconds.
Yes, that's 64 seconds.
64.2.
Here it is, 64 seconds.
We have to trust you. Yes. Okay, and you give a 10 seconds warning. It was very beautiful. Very nice. Yes, yes, yes. And so organic how you...
Yeah, it seemed to
go. And the timing was, I think, perfect. Was it not, Henry? Don't complain back there. Don't lose that one. It was very, very beautiful. Yes, very, very
good. No, you're better than the other.
Really?
Yeah, I didn't like that.
Yes, yes, don't listen to them if they want to have a repeat.
Okay. Never been active.
I can hear it better because I'm that close. Forget about the mechanics in there.
Stand by.
Let them do it.
Yeah.
They thought about it, and we'll see what happens.
The reason I'd like to do it is it's a very spotty scene.
Unbelievable, kid. Unbelievable. Like 10 to 1 10 scale. One best thing he's ever done.
It's not movie. No. I just tie your hands.
I love you.
Yeah. And trample on your guitar if you tried something. That was music, yes.
Richard's singing a song through his guitar, right?
I see it not like in jazz sessions where all of a sudden, let's say, percussion is left alone and does its brilliance, shows its brilliance, and then the guitar is playing and does the riff, or however you call it. And it's not of that sort. Yeah, there's nothing hectic in it. Thank you.
Well, there's no greater joy than living and working and breathing music with such intensity for, unfortunately, a short period of time only. And it's absolutely world-class musicians here. There's nothing better. I mean, I could sit back and I know I'm privileged.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Wherever it was.